kings ever.
Somebody just got pregnant.
Hated it.
I'm John. Okay, I go by Paper Tiger.
And that you can print. That's how it goes.
Print one of those for me.
I am Laserbeak. I make beats for Doomtree.
Okay. 90. My name is Sims. My name is Andrew Sims. AKA Sims.
What was that?
30.
Sims cup. Wow.
What's a Sims cup?
It's like a Pim's cup, except it's just full of booze.
You want to accept the Doomtree? Don't let it be known. From the bottom of the bottle, top of the throne.
I'm Cecil Otter.
I'm Steph, I'm POS, the rapper from Doomtree.
How come you're always filming me beating Dessa?
Capture this.
What the fuck?
Because he never
shut up.
He never.
My name is Dessa, and I'm a rapper in Doomtree.
Unitarian is just like Catholicism, but with masturbating.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mike McLaughlin.
I rap out of my mouth, I make people's faces melt. My name is Mike McLaughlin, the Aztec death rapper from Doomtree, Minneapolis.
Hey, we're Doomtree.
Hey,
we're
Doomtree.
We're Doomtree.
I think usually we write and produce alone, then come together and try to blend all of the elements that we've created independently.
So like, well, let's try this if we're gonna make a posse record, because we said from the jump we want no solo songs, we want all posse cuts, then why not really make it a posse album and have everyone make the beats together too?
This one is the most collaborative, whereas I think before we worried about having people equally represented.
If we came into it knowing that we were all making the beat and we were all a process of it, it wasn't a matter of trying to like be the star of the beat. It doesn't even really cross our minds to work that way. I think that definitely set it up for just true collaboration for the first time for us, not just in little pairs, but all of us really working together.
612, you're listening to the Music Box on 89.5 FM. I'm your host, Jesse Menendez. My in-studio guests from Doomtree are POS, Mike McLaughlin, and Sims.
For this album, I understand you guys went to a log cabin or cabin. it's Lincoln's birthday just passed. I'm sure. I have a log cabin on the brain. A cabin in Wisconsin to write this.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Was there something significant about this location?
Not the location so much as all of us are incredibly busy people, and all of us have, you know, a lot of lives and work and things like that. I think the plan was to get far enough away from, like, cell phone coverage that we couldn't be bothered for a week to actually try to get something done together.
Did the isolation help with the writing?
It did. I mean, we kind of went up there like, all right, we have 5 days. We are supposed to record in 2 weeks, and then 2 weeks after that, the record's supposed to be mastered. This is the first time we set a release date before we wrote a song, which is, for any artists out there, that's not the move. but that's what we did. And so we kind of went up there like knowing we had to get this whole album done, but we took a little bit of the pressure off because when we collaborate, we don't necessarily work at a steady clip. You know, we sort of do a thing. Or
you're saying it's not the move, but here we are sitting, you're on a successful tour. Maybe honestly, this is the move.
Honestly, I think maybe. It kind of has been the move. Like, I feel like it's not necessarily, I mean, it was a big risky move to like set a date with our distributor before we start. But all of us as a collective and as individuals have worked really well at the last minute for the whole time.
This year's Blowout is way different because we're doing a whole fucking week. We're doing 7 days in a row as opposed to last year we tried to do 2, which got stretched to 3 because of the snowstorm.
And we have 7 of us, and it all made sense, you know. So we did 5 nights in the entry. Each of the rappers had their own night, curated it, brought, you know, all their own openers, and then, you know, 2 nights in the main room.
Performance-wise, I've never been able to top that feeling of playing with those 6 people at First Avenue for the Blowout, and just fucking rules.
It's like my birthday and Christmas and all the other things that people would say are holidays at the same time. The Blowout started as Doomtree, as a bunch of babies trying to figure out if we could, how many people we can get to come to our show with nobody else in the bill. Because up to the point of the first Blowout, there had never been just a Doomtree show where it was just us on the bill.
I'm half really excited to get out there and tour again, but really, like, I don't like tour. I love shows.
The nights are a lot of fun, but I think it's no joke about trying to just maintain your organism to be able to rock out that hard for 2 hours every night, and then to spend, you know, 6 or 7 or 8 hours every day with your knees against the seat in front of you in a van.
I think it's gonna be like 3 months. It's like the longest I've ever been out.
I really hate being in the van because I can't get anything done. And I'm like this death-obsessed kid who's always like counting down her remaining hours to make something of herself. So I hate to imagine them, you know, any of them wasted in transit, essentially. But that's the hardest part. And there is no one else alive, I think, who I'd rather be cramped in a van with. So the company will be great, and the driving will suck. So.